Hi, J.P. Fournier of the Movie Jerks here, and today is day 5 of Sci-Fi September, the month where I force myself to watch a brand new science fiction film that I've never seen every day. And let's see what we have for day 5. We have Cosmos. Okay, that's a colorful poster. Only they will hear, only they will believe. Three astronomers accidentally intercept what they believe is a signal from a distant alien civilization. But the truth is more incredible than any of them could have imagined. Okay, well, that sounds promising. So day 5, we are watching Cosmos. Very ambitious, low-budget film succeeds in delivering the spirit of movie magic you might expect from a film by Steven Spielberg. Well, perhaps more of a poor man Spielberg. However, that's still meant as a compliment. The film is basically three men sitting in a vehicle listening to the stars for 2 hours and 8 minutes. Well, technically the listening part's probably more of an hour and 45 minutes, but nonetheless. During the hour and 45 minutes, our leads engage in some verbal squabbles, then followed by some motivational and inspirational speeches to one another, causing their transactions to feel a bit sappy and a little too melodramatic. But these three characters are likable. They're humble men trying to accomplish the impossible, and therefore they're easy to root for. Cosmos stays relatively straight and on point when it comes to the topic of communicating with outer worlds. Science fiction fans may compare it to other alien contact movies like Close Encounters of the Third Kind, Contact, or Clara, a film that we mentioned in our Science Fiction Movies That Deserve More Attention video. In Close Encounters, we have an underlining theme of racism. This is shown in the fearlessness of a child free of conditioned immoral prejudices, and how we can communicate with alien beings while we cannot communicate with other countries within our own world. Contact debates the ability to mix spirituality with scientific knowledge.
Dr. Arroway, would you consider yourself a spiritual person?
I don't really understand the point of the question.
And Clara beautifully displays the inviting, luminous, and serene quality of our euphoric ability to experience such emotions as love. And Cosmos is just about three guys who may have discovered a new signal from outer space. However, where this film lacks in a deeper meaning, it does display a lot of knowledge in the science of communication and the importance of research, such as satellite frequencies.
Look, it's transmitting. I mean, these pulses, they sync with the clicks coming through the tuner.
There wasn't a bounce back at all. It was being broadcast from orbit.
Sounds like Morse code.
No, it's binary.
Yet I did find it a bit odd that a movie that understands so much detail about space and time, logic and physics, and sound versus distance, happens to have a poor sense of movie timing. And this becomes more apparent when the film springs into action and our would-be heroes appear to talk more about how urgent everything is instead of getting their ass in gear.
We've got 18 minutes. If we're gonna go, we gotta go right now.
Mike, we'll never make it.
We can make it. I'll get you there. Tell me what to do.
Okay, let's do it. We'll get the gear. You cut loose what you can.
Wait, Harry! Hey, what if there's more to come?
No! What are you waiting for? Do it!
Even in the race sequence, which is a lot of fun, there seems to be a misunderstanding of the speed in which the car is driving. I blame this on editing. Because knowing how fast this car appears to be driven, there is too much chatter about a red light before they hit the red light that your brain starts telling you that they should have already hit this red light seconds ago.
Roy, red light, Roy. Red light, Roy, red light.
Time.
Less than 4 minutes. Do it! Just do it!
Now, this is nitpicking, I understand, and some people may not even notice these details. But regardless of my nitpicks, I still got lost in the action because I enjoy these characters and I did want to see them succeed. In the end, the film could have easily shed 15 to 20 minutes. But regardless of that, it still provides a satisfying finale that is worth the price of admission. And I watched this free on Tubi, so... And there we go, day 5 of Sci-Fi September. This time we watched Cosmos. If you've seen this film, we'd love to hear your comments in the comment section. And if you're curious about the other films we're watching this month, be sure to subscribe to get notifications each day. And for more information about The Movie Jerks, you can go to www.themoviejerks.ca.